Welcome to the 11th Annual Victor Emanuel Conservation Award Celebration at home, honoring Shelia Hargis. We're excited to celebrate conservation in a new way this year. We thank you for being here. First, I'd like to raise a glass to our honoree, Shelia Hargis, as well as to the mission of Travis Audubon. Shelia, congratulations, and here's to you. Our program today is full of surprises and inspirational moments, and we hope that you enjoy everyone. But I'd like to start off by saying thank you. Thank you so much to our sponsors whose generosity is such a great support to us. Thank you to our members and our donors without whom we could not do this important work. And thank you to each and every one of you who have chosen to spend this time with us. We appreciate you. Like many of you, Travis Audubon celebrated a quarantine birthday this year. On March 15th, we turned 68 years old. The pandemic and economic decline that followed have been the biggest challenges that Travis Audubon has ever faced in its history. But because of your strong support, we are weathering the storm. Many nonprofits during this time are struggling to stay afloat, and we thank you for your generous support. We couldn't do our work without you. Normally, at this event, we would set a goal of $100,000, and we had no idea what 2020 would bring or if we would be able to meet that goal. But because of your generous sponsorships and early donations, we have already raised $55,000 towards that goal. So let's go for it. Let's raise an additional $45,000 for Travis Audubon's programs and operations during this event. We know with your support we can do it. Thank you so much in advance for your generosity. You can donate by clicking on the donate button. Don't forget to bid on items in our fabulous silent auction, which will be open until tomorrow evening. Now I'm honored to introduce our first guest, one of many conservation legends that we'll hear from today. Entrepreneur, birding enthusiast, namesake, and first recipient of our conservation award, and a champion of mentorship through birding. Here's our friend and inspiration, Victor Emanuel.
Thank you for attending this virtual celebration of the Travis Audubon event to honor Shelia Hargis for all the work she's done in conservation. I'm thrilled that you're all watching here, and I wish we could all be around a table together and be seeing each other in person. But it's still going to be a great day. And we're all together supporting Travis Audubon for the important work it does. And that work is more important than ever. Nature and birds have been more important during these challenging times than ever in our lives. They provide solace, they provide healing, and we need to repay birds and nature by supporting Travis Audubon for all the important work that it does. Work that is more important than ever. So let's all resolve to do that, to support Travis Audubon more than we ever have. And I look forward to the time when we can all be back out in nature and birds, enjoying their beauty and the solace that they give us.
Hi, Shelia. Hi, everybody. I'm Ed Fair. I probably know most of you guys because I've been birding around Austin for 20 years, and I'm the founder of the Commons Ford Prairie Restoration Project, which we started in 2010, and I continued to work with until I escaped to Costa Rica a couple of years ago. We're out in nature right now in Costa Rica, so you might hear some birds chirping and some dogs barking. But more importantly, how did I meet Shelia Hargis? I met her because I participated in some of her Christmas bird counts in Austin, some of her field trips. We quickly became friends and did a whole lot of birding together. Eventually, I brought her to Commons Ford because I knew she would fall in love with it, which she did. And if you know her, you know that she's going to become obsessed with it, which she did. She got involved, became a member of the committee, became the chair of the committee, became the driving force behind the project, and has helped shape it, give it direction and focus, and has helped turn it into something that I believe will be long-lasting. So why does Shelia deserve this project aside from the obvious? If you looked up volunteer in the dictionary, you should see a picture of Shelia, because she never says no and she never sleeps. We know that she loves to teach new birders, not just because she wants to teach them about birds, but because she wants to instill in them an excitement about birding, which she does, and that is the same excitement that she had when she first became a birder. But also, you do know she's a little crazy, right? If not, ask her later when you see her how many times she's met me at 2:30 in the morning in South Austin so that we could drive down to Choke Canyon, do the Christmas bird count, rush back to Austin and do another one the next day, right? Or just ask her how many Christmas bird counts she did last year. My favorite is, ask her how many times when I'm driving down the highway 60 miles an hour, she yells at me, stop, 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 because she heard a little warbler chirp across the road. Okay, but it really, honestly, is my honor and pleasure to get to introduce this great video in recognition of Shelia and all of her accomplishments and her designation as this year's Victor Emanuel Conservation Award honoree. We want to thank Lydia Saldana and her crew and all these great special guests that you're going to see in this video shortly. So I hope you enjoy it. Shelia, we love you. Keep inspiring us. Keep going. See you later.
Like a look, I think. Oh, I think there's one circling around now. So this one looks like maybe a teenager. Oh, so it's a young bird. Look for the eyes. The eyes are not white yet. Oh, here he is. I can kind of see him through here. Well, I love birds. Oh, here's a kingbird flying. They have been transformational in my life. You have to come up here, Ellen, probably to see it. There it goes right there. I don't know what it was about birds, but it's like I just decided that, okay, you got to let your passion show fully. They don't understand how fast my bird walks progress.
Kim wanted to do the beginner's class with Shelia.
And once we took Sheila's class, we just turned into avid birders in, gosh, 2 months. I'm trying to learn how to make that little ch-ch-ch sound she makes. I can't remember what they call it.
That's called pishing.
It's like she brings the birds out of the bush when she does that.
She is very good with young birders and beginner birders. That patience really lets her listen to them and help convey some of her passion about birds and conservation.
The passion isn't something she turns on and off.
When Shelia was board president for Travis Audubon in the early 2000s, she was instrumental in helping us to expand our sanctuaries.
It's a mated pair.
They're important enough to secure their future. It's important enough that I engage other people in working toward that future also.
Here we go. Oh!
So most people think when they hear the term crime analyst, they think, oh, it's just like CSI, right?
And make sure that the data was all verified. So.
But it's actually not the forensic stuff. This is a case that's a murder case.
Because you can see around the murder location, there aren't.
We are the people at APD who are analyzing data, trying to help prevent crime or solve crime or mitigate crime.
Well, I'm not familiar with birding, but I'll tell you what makes a good crime analyst and how I think it would relate to birding is Shelia's ability to go down the rat hole, so to speak. Her attention to detail and her tenacity in researching those types of things is what makes her a great crime analyst and probably what makes her a good birding person.
And so we're here tonight waiting for the martins to come in.
They're starting to come in, like, right now.
Travis Audubon has been holding Purple Martin parties for quite a few years now.
It's amazing.
Not only were our eyes opened, but also hearing things that we've never heard before.
It's like a hurricane of birds.
They'll go, "Oh my God, there's birds everywhere." And I'm going, "Yes, there's birds everywhere." So it's opening their eyes and ears to what's been around them this whole time. So yeah, super cool. Just like, it's just heaven.
Hi, I'm Eric Steger, the president of the board of Travis Audubon. COVID-19 has changed so many things about daily life for each of us. For Travis Audubon, it's affected our ability to do in-person programming and field trips, which are such an important part of how we connect to the public about our mission. But we've been coming up with creative ways to inspire conservation through birding despite the pandemic.
We're so happy that you've chosen to be with us today. Welcome to our summer lunchtime lecture series featuring Shelia Hargis.
Many of you have participated in our virtual lunch series and our Birding Together in Spirit programs, and we're launching even more, including bird bingo, new virtual classes, and online bird trivia. We also have an exciting new program in partnership with the Ann Richards School called the Young Women in Conservation Program, which will teach students about wildlife conservation and the various career paths that are possible in the conservation field. This year will be virtual, but in the future we'll include field trips and a year-end campout. So these are hard times, but they're also a time to reflect on the role we play in our community. And right now it's a time to celebrate our organization and our honoree, Shelia Hargis. There's never been a better time in our 68 years of existence to show your support for Travis Audubon than this very minute. Now I'd like to introduce Gail Stallings, our auctioneer extraordinaire, who's helped us more than ever this year in moving to a virtual fundraising event. Thanks, Gail, for all your help this year and over the past 11 years. Take it away.
Thank you, Eric. Good evening, friends. I am so happy to be with you as your fundraising host. And as I'm looking forward to this day when we can all be together in person, I'm excited to join you tonight. And because I'm a member of Travis Audubon, take it from me, this is such a great cause to support. I'd like you to join me in celebrating birds, their habitat, and our 2020 conservation hero, Shelia Hargis. Yes! Yay, Shelia! We love you! Whether you're watching on your mobile device or computer, you can donate from either one. To make a donation, tap the donate button on your screen. You can select a level or choose your own donation amount, whatever is meaningful to you. You've been hearing how COVID-19 has revealed both challenges and opportunities for Travis Audubon. Birds and wildlife need our support now more than ever, and we humans are relying on them more than ever to inspire us through these difficult times. Now is your opportunity to make a difference for wildlife. During our virtual paddle raise this year, instead of holding up your bidder number, you are going to hit that donate button. All gifts that you make today are 100% tax deductible and will go towards the operation and programming of Travis Audubon. Your gift will help Travis Audubon do its important work to protect birds and restore the places where they can thrive. We can't do this without you, so we thank you so much for your continued support. So let's get started with our Raise the Paddle, folks. What do you say? Let me tell you the impact your donation can make at each of these levels. Your gift of $2,000 will protect and keep the sanctuaries humming. At $1,000, restore and develop Blair Woods Sanctuary. Your gift of $500, we're gonna use that for technology to virtually inspire a love of native birds. At $250, this is the exclusive When the Going Gets Tough, the Tough Go Birding. It's a patch and match. I'm excited to tell you more about that. And at $100, inspire conservation through birding. This is your chance to make an impact and give from the heart. Watch the chat box to see those donations coming in. I'm gonna be watching some monitors. Now they're rolling in fast already and at different amounts, and we are so grateful to you. Keep them coming. And while you're entering those donations, I wanna share a few of the programs and how your gift will help Travis Audubon. With a gift of $2,000, you can make a huge impact at our sanctuaries. For birds like the chimney swift and the endangered golden cheek warbler, they can thrive in their habitat that's gonna be protected forever. A huge thank you. I see Carol Ray for saying yes to a gift at $2,000. Yes, you can. You can feel free to join her with your gift at $2,000. Thank you, Carol. We appreciate you so much. And I bet that felt so good to give. Your support at $2,000 allows us to do this essential habitat work. From chipping brush to participating in survey counts, you can join other supporters and help us keep our sanctuaries humming. Go ahead, hit that donate button, because I know that we all want Texans 100 years from now to see and hear these birds. There are so many donations coming in right now, and this is a great reminder that we can't do this alone, but we can do this together. Moving on to other ways you can help. Every dollar makes a difference. At the $1,000 level, you can help us restore nature and explore the important history at Blair Woods Sanctuary. How many of you have been to Blair Woods? If you have not been to this urban oasis, put this on your to-do list. Not only is this the focus of the education programming at Travis Audubon, this sanctuary is a wellspring of incredible connections with native wildlife, Austin history, and our East Austin neighbors. I want to thank Joe Wilson for a gift of $1,000. Thank you, Joe. I can picture you at your middle table. But you're not there right now, but you're on your couch or somewhere. And then there's Laura Leggett and Joe Doherty with their gift of $1,500. Thank you, Laura and Joe. Think of Blair Woods. Think of how it straddles both our rich past and our exciting future. And your support of $1,000 helps it to develop and thrive. Come on now, let's break all the goals and then the dream goals. After all, Travis Audubon has big plans for this site. They're restoring the historic barn as an outdoor classroom space. This is gonna reach even more kids and neighbors. That is so exciting, and you can be part of this. For all the gifts coming in at $1,000, thank you for being part of this bright future for Blair Woods, because communities need more access to green spaces. Here's another way you can help. Your gift of $500 will allow Travis Audubon to update technology and software with new virtual tools and training and general operational support to help us weather the storm. I'm going to give you two reasons why we need your support for this technology. Number one, Travis Audubon has seen that more people are noticing and becoming interested in birds during the pandemic. There's been a 30% increase in membership, and we're still growing. Reason number two, over the summer, registration for the weekly lunchtime lecture series maxed out. Yes, more than 1,000 people took part. We virtually created bird-friendly backyards, birded in the Guatemalan cloud forest, went on magical migrations, and so much more. Thank you, yes, Clifton and Brenda Ladd, for your gift at $500. And joining them are the members of the Commons Ford Prairie Committee. Yes, we absolutely love when entire committees make a gift. Join them and have a chance at the best kind of gift. This one fits in your heart and has no expiration date. All right, I found one more reason for this technology. As Eric mentioned, this fall, Travis Audubon is piloting the Young Women in Conservation Program with the Ann Richards School. What an opportunity to be able to conduct this program during the pandemic. Maybe the next Shelia Hargis will take part in that program. So go ahead and click that donate button right now for $500. I'm excited to tell you about this very special incentive this year at the $250 level. It's a match and a patch. In honor of Shelia's work, restoring the prairie, right here at Commons Ford, we have a fabulous match of $10,000. Yes, you can start clapping. And this is provided by a generous Travis Audubon member and our friends at the Winkler Family Foundation. Yes, $10,000 calls for you to make lots of virtual noise. This generous match will apply for all gifts at the $250 level and above. Plus, wait, there's still more. Any donations at $250 or higher will also receive this stunning limited edition commemorative patch that features one of our favorite birds of the prairie, the scissor-tailed flycatcher. We know that birding has been a solace for so many of us during the pandemic. I noticed I'm taking more birding breaks during the day. And what better way to commemorate this silver lining than with this patch to remind ourselves that when the going gets tough, the tough go birding. So go ahead, stretch a little bit more and hit that button for $250 for the match and patch with the scissor-tailed flycatcher. All right, Celeste Treadway, you've got a match and a patch coming your way. And thank you to Andy and Ellen Filtness, as well as Flo Rice, for your gifts of $250. While the world feels most uncertain, the one thing is certain. Your gift of $250 will be doubled. And Travis Audubon will continue to be your voice for conservation, education, and advocacy. So many gifts coming in for this match and patch. Here's another one from our friends, Deb and Lee Wallace. Thank you. And what a great mantra for all of us for 2020. When the going gets tough, the tough go birding. I'm about out of time. You can make a difference at the $100 level. You are standing up for birds, helping Travis Audubon create new programming, maintaining our hardworking staff, and ensuring that we'll be here for another 68 years after COVID is long gone. Now's the time to hit the button at $100. Every gift matters. I see you, Suzanne Coe and Lee Walker. Thank you so much. More $100 gifts from Caroline Jones and Ed Fair. Thank you. And you too can inspire conservation through birding. Thank you so much for all these donations. This is truly an amazing way to show your support. No gift is too big or too small. even if I didn't call it out, you can enter any amount and click the donate button. So let's keep those gifts rolling in. On behalf of everyone at Travis Audubon, thank you so much for your generosity. For the 11th year, it's been my pleasure to be a part of the Victor Emanuel Conservation Awards, and I look forward to seeing you next year.
Wow, thank you so much, Gail, for your tremendous support with our fundraising this year and every year. And thanks to each of you who have donated. You are helping us do our work to inspire conservation through birding. Now it's time for two more legends of Travis Audubon to be in conversation about the work that makes our world go round. You've gotten to know Shelia already, but it's my honor to also introduce you to Valerie Bristol, our Victor Emanuel Conservation Award winner from 2016 and former Travis Audubon board president. Valerie is a lawyer and former county commissioner and was instrumental in establishing the Balcones Canyonland Preserve in 1996, which protects more than 30,000 acres of land for water quality, endangered species, including the golden-cheeked warbler, and open spaces for public use. Longtime friends and collaborators, Shelia and Valerie share a passion for conservation and protecting birds and habitats. And you're about to see this true powerhouse duo in action. Please enjoy these conservation heroes in conversation together.
Hi, this is my pleasure to get to visit with Shelia Hargis today and explain to you a little bitty bit of why it is she's winning this wonderful award. Everybody knows that Shelia is a terrific birder, but what they don't always know is all the other things that she's done. But birding is what started it all, Shelia. How did you get involved in birding?
Well, I took my beginning birding class in the summer of 1996, and it was taught by Fred and Marie Webster. And for everyone who knew them, they're quite a hoot and did a wonderful job with the class. And I saw my first male painted bunting during that class. And so I left it being very intrigued by birds. And so then I joined Travis Audubon, and I was very fortunate to have several Travis Audubon members who took me under their wings. You know, there were a lot, but there were two that come to mind, and that's Lawrence Buford and Gene Martin. You know, they took me on field trips. They took me on Christmas bird counts. They really, I caught the birding bug from them. And so I continued to go on field trips with Travis Audubon, and I took all of the amazing Travis Audubon classes. And yes, I took some of them numerous times, but it all paid off, and my skills are better than, they have progressed during the years. And so I now teach classes and lead field trips and give presentations and conduct bird surveys and basically, you know, spend all of my free time watching and enjoying birds or thinking about birds and bird conservation. So, yeah. I mean, some people might say I'm obsessed with birds. I'm not sure.
Well, Shelia, one of the outstanding things you've done is your teaching and your leading, and your classes have brought in so many new birders. What's so exciting about teaching new birders?
Well, teaching the Intro to Birds class was very special. I mean, no offense to any of the other instructors, but I had the best students. I mean, they so rocked, and so they made the class really special. Rachel Carson wrote about a sense of wonder, and she wrote, "A child's world is fresh and new and beautiful, full of wonder and excitement." And for kids, that's kind of like a natural state. But then as we grow up and the demands of the world imposed upon us, we typically lose that sense of wonder. Well, birds for me reignited my sense of wonder, and it transformed my life. And so I always looked at the Intro to Birds class as an opportunity to potentially reignite my students' sense of wonder by encouraging and celebrating their connection to birds. And so it was a very special opportunity to do that.
Wow. Well, another way that you have helped Travis Audubon so much and all the people who are involved with it, is you had a vision and an understanding that as the city exploded and grew, that Travis Audubon, which was an all-volunteer organization when you became president, needed to move forward and began to have an executive staff, executive director. And it was your leadership that started that process. And you've also taken that leadership of organizational skills over to the Texas Ornithological Society. So you're helping two important organizations in Texas be more organized as they deliver the joy of birding. So tell us a little bit about that journey.
Well, as you said, you know, as a board member and especially as board president, I felt very strongly that Travis Audubon needed to be the most effective conservation organization it could be as quickly as possible. And so this belief led the board to hire Valerie Statz as our executive director. And Valerie came to us with knowledge and skills and experience about how to run a nonprofit organization effectively and efficiently. And she helped us organize our efforts, create new programs, raise money like we had not done that before, buy land, and just overall raise our standing in the community as a conservation organization. And that was just the start. The boards and executive directors that have followed continued to move the organization forward. And I'm so proud of the progress Travis Audubon has made. Now we not only have an amazing executive director in Nicole, we have four other staff members, and all of them are doing a wonderful job as we inspire conservation through birding.
Well, it's been a great journey to have it with you. And also, though, one of the key components of this Victor Emanuel Award is conservation. So I want to tip my hat and remind everyone, you added acreage to Baker Sanctuary. You helped bring in Keturah Canyon and the wonderful Kyles and the management of that organization. You've also brought in the Commons Ford Prairie to Travis Audubon's management and leadership. And over in the Taos area, Ornithological Society, you've done work adding acreage to Magic Ridge. Wonderful conservation work. I'm sure I missed something,
but that's
been awesome.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about, you know, why you do that.
Well, habitat destruction and degradation are major threats to our birds. You know, some birds can adapt to urban human-made environments. Think great-tailed grackle, right? They're doing fine. But most species can't adapt. And if we don't provide a safe place for them, protect the habitats that they require, then we'll lose them. And that's not acceptable to me. And it's why conservation work is so important to me. And, you know, kind of on a personal level, it feels really good when I can play a part in saving land, either by my personal donations or by my actions as a part of an organization to work toward this conservation. And then it's especially satisfying to actually go to that protected land after it's protected and see the birds that are benefiting from our efforts. So birds, you know, in my opinion, birds bring so much joy to our lives and they face so many challenges. It seems the least we can do is provide them safe places as they navigate our world.
Well, I couldn't agree more. And that's exactly why I am so proud and pleased to present to you, which is having in this time of COVID, the award is now already with you, which you can show us in just a moment. But you are the Victor Emanuel Conservation Award winner of 2020. Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm very honored to receive this award. And, you know, when I think of my journey to this day, it's very clear to me that I'm being honored with this award because Travis Audubon and Travis Audubon members provided me the opportunities to fall in love with birds and to contribute in many ways. And I'm forever grateful that I found Travis Audubon. I stood on the shoulders of so many people and had tremendous support throughout my birding and conservation life, that if I was able to thank everyone that I want to thank, we would be here for a couple more hours. But Nicole has said I can't quite talk that long, so I'm going to thank a few very special people. And, you know, those special people start with Lawrence Buford and Jean Martin, both for mentoring me, but also for showing me how important it is to be a mentor so that I can step up and be a mentor, you know, once I have the skills. Valerie, you and Jeff Monday, I was so honored to get to serve on the Travis Audubon board with both of you. You brought vast experience with habitat conservation to the board, and I learned so much from you. And then Valerie Statz, as my executive director, Valerie, you were so awesome to work with. And again, I learned so much from you. And then there are my Intro to Bird students. You were so special. You made the class really a highlight of my life. And I could not have taught that class without my assistants, Lori Foss and Cheryl McGrath. You helped me coordinate and have it be a wonderful experience for everyone. And then there's my Birdathon team members. Throughout the years, we have raised significant money for Travis Audubon. And we also did pretty good on our species list each year. So I'm very proud of that. And then finally, thank you to all who are here attending this event. I love you all, and may your days be filled with the beauty of birds. Thank you.
Thank you, Valerie, and congratulations, Shelia. We're so inspired by you and grateful for your work. Friends, it's such an honor that you chose to be with Travis Audubon this evening, and we're so grateful. But we can't let you go without one more special touch in Shelia's honor. Many of you may know that one of Shelia's favorite musical artists is John Denver, and we couldn't pass up the chance to combine the musical stylings of Mr. Denver with the beautiful voice of Andy Sansom, another Victor Emanuel Conservation Award winner, this time from 2011. As we end the program, we invite you to join us in a special sing-along featuring vocals by Andy of Take Me Home, Birdie Roads, a composition with lyrics in Shelia's honor. Thank you, thank you, thank you for being here, and good night. Take it away, Andy.
Birding heaven, Austin, Texas. Shelia Hargis, conservation hero. She helps birds thrive, build their nests and feed. Prairie restoration, there for all to see. Birdie Road, here we go. So many birds, let's see them all. Painted bunting, turkey vulture, here we go, down Birdie Road. All the birders appreciate her, Shelia Hargis, teacher of beginners. Look at that one, a raven or a crow. Patiently she answers, do they call a croak? Birdie Road, here we go. So many birds, let's see them all. Northern bobwhite, common nighthawk. Here we go, down Birdie Road. And will we bird in the morning at 4:30? And also when it's hotter than the surface of the sun? Shelia is your friend who'll go out birding, looking for those live birds any day, any day. Here we go down Birdie Road. so many birds. Let's see them all common grackle, purple martin, here we go down Birdie Row.
From the Kyles
and Keturah Canyon,
Thank you.
Thank you very much for supporting Travis Audubon. We'll be right back.